So the first question, the best case running time for a given input size is no longer than the best measured time for each algorithm. This is true. To think about this, all you really need to do is realize that by definition, the best case running time is better than all other possible running times. So if there's one smaller than it, well, it's not really the best, is it? And you can think of the same thing for the worst case running time for the second one, which is also true. The worst case running time for a given input size is at least the worst measured time for each algorithm, because if there is a worse or a longer measured time than the worst case running time, well, then it's not worst, is it? Now, for the third question, algorithm beta is the fastest for all inputs. This is actually false. And even though it's actually true for all of the inputs that we tested, it might not be true for much smaller inputs. For example, n equals 1 or 2. We can't say that it's the fastest for all inputs because, well, we haven't tested it on all inputs. That might very well be the case, but in order to say that, we actually would need to test it, and that's not really feasible. And for the final question, we're asking if for small inputs, the algorithm with exponential behavior is faster than the algorithm with polynomial behavior. And this is actually true. If you look at alpha and gamma, alpha being the exponential algorithm and gamma being the polynomial one, it actually is faster. 25 minutes is quite a bit faster than 500. So this is actually true. And it's interesting to see that sometimes for small inputs, an exponential algorithm isn't really that big of a deal.